Massive protests erupted in the U.S. on September 23rd, condemning the grand jury's verdict on the Breonna Taylor case. Protests happened in major cities, including Washington, D.C., New York, Los Angeles, Atlanta, Portland, Seattle, and Louisville, where Breonna was shot dead by cops. The protests were triggered after a jury in the U.S. state of Kentucky refused to charge the three officers involved in the fatal shooting of medical worker Breonna Taylor. Instead of a murder indictment, as was requested by Taylor's family and supporters in a lawsuit claiming wrongful death, the jury only sanctioned indictment against one of the officers for supposedly endangering the lives of the victim's neighbors with police firing.
The AG in Kentucky is not filing any homicide charges against the three officers that murdered Breonna Taylor. Okay. The DOJ that y'all met at has a role in Breonna Taylor's case. And right now, we are demanding that Breonna Taylor's case be escalated to the DOJ because clearly her civil liberties were violated.
We say defund the police. It is a commitment to refunding the people. There are over $115 billion that are spent on police forces across this nation. But they tell us that they can't erase college debt. There's over $115 billion being spent on policing in this nation. But they tell us that housing and healthcare can't be a human right in an advanced nation in the 21st century.
Brett Hankinson, who was expelled from the Louisville Metro Police Department, will be facing three charges of wanton endangerment for blindly firing 10 rounds of bullets at a neighbor's apartment window. The jury brought up the low-level felony charges, which only carry a maximum prison sentence of 5 years each. The jury also decided to let off Jonathan Mattingly and Miles Cosgrove, who had shot 20 rounds at Taylor and her partner inside her apartment. The jury rejected the family's lawsuit despite the fact that forensics had found 6 bullets on Taylor's body. It was also established that Cosgrove's bullet had killed Taylor. The jury was impaneled by Kentucky State Attorney General Daniel Cameron, who is from the Republican Party. The Taylor family have expressed their disappointment with the outcome of the lawsuit, which their lawyer characterizes outrageous and offensive. Louisville has been witnessing major protests and demonstrations since March, demanding justice for Taylor, which only intensified after the killing of George Floyd in May and the consequent nationwide protests. According to reports, the police in Louisville preemptively fired flashbangs and tear gas at demonstrators 30 minutes before a curfew was set to begin. The police repression also led to 127 arrests across the city, with further repression expected as protests continued to intensify.